Hi everyone, welcome back to BankExamsToday.com, and we are here on day 21 of 5 minutes vocabulary, and we are just 9 days away from completing this series, because it was a 30 days series in which I'm going to teach you 5 minutes vocabulary or vocabulary for your bank exams or other competitive exams. So today we are going to learn 5 new words as usual, their meaning, synonyms, antonyms and example. Before we start, let me tell you that many students comment, why don't you provide PDF? So we do provide PDF, which is available in the description board, that you can download that PDF and save it in your mobile phones. And on the 30th day, we will definitely provide you a combined PDF of day 1 to day 30. So it will be a PDF of 150 words that you can save in your desktop or in your mobile phones. So we will start with the word renunciation. Renunciation is a word when we use to describe a person's activity of giving up. Like you see, we have sadhus, sons and yogis. Yogis live in Himalayas. They do tapasya. Okay. So what do? They give up all the worldly pleasures in order to attain moksha. Right? Renunciation is to give up, formally give up everything to follow a path. Sometimes to become a saint, a person has to renounce all the comforts of life. That is called renunciation. Synonyms will be repudiation, rejection and abandonment, because you leave, you abandon everything. Okay, antonyms will be agreement, because you accept it. Approval, claim, sanction or assertion. Example, in order to join the cult. Cult is a word used for a group of people following a religion or a particular saint or preacher. That is called cult. Remember, members must take part in renunciation of outside world. It means in order to become a member of the cult, people have to renounce, give up the outside world. Then comes the word distrait. Distrait, when the word start with dis, you must understand it is always negative. So distrait is a word used when we are mentioning a person who is always absent-minded, who does not know what is happening around him. Like he is distracted, his mind is somewhere else. He is so absorbed in his thoughts that he does not know if anybody is talking around him, if anybody is working around him. Okay, he does not pay attention. That is distrait. Synonyms will be distracted, preoccupied, because you are busy in something, absorbed, engrossed or abstracted. Antonyms, alert, because here when you are distrait, you don't pay attention. But when you are alert, you do pay attention. Then concentrating, aware, attentive or heedful. Example, on the way, doctor was distrait, only Annie was speaking. It means doctor was lost in his thoughts and Annie was speaking, but doctor was not paying attention. Then the word comes irascible. Irascible is used for a person who gets angry really quickly. It can be your mother, father, brother, sister, friend, who is very short tempered. Or little things annoy that person. In this case, here is my sister who gets angry very quickly. Even though she commits something stupid, but she has to vent her anger out on somebody else. And she gets angry really quickly and very easily. On small things, on little things as well. So that is irascible. Synonyms, irritable, because that person becomes irritated very quickly. Quick-tempered, because that person is unable to handle her temperament or his temperament. Ill-tempered or hot-tempered. Antonyms, companionable, friendly, congenial or sociable. Or you can use all these antonyms An example, because Charles is very irascible, you have to be mindful of what you say to him. Because when a person gets easily angry, you have to be very careful what you speak. Then comes the word inimical. Like, this person is inimical. This person has a tendency to harm this lady. This person is having some serious dangerous tendency. He's unfriendly. He's not, you can say he looks dangerous to other person. Like, so inimical is used for a person or a thing that has the tendency to harm or obstruct our work. Synonyms: harmful, because obviously if it is harming, it will harm you. Injurious, it will injure you. Detrimental, deleterious. Antonyms: agreeable, because that person agrees. Approving, understanding, amiable. The police officer had an inimical attitude towards criminal, because that police officer harms criminals, so he is inimical. The last word we have is subvert. Subvert means to undermine the power and authority. For example, people of a nation come together and start protesting against the ruling government. They want to undermine or they want to demolish all the power government has and start, they want to remove them from the authority. That is called subvert. Like ISIS, it's subverting the authority in Libya. There are other nations who are the target of ISIS, and ISIS is subverting the authorities and powers in different nations. So subverting means first you attack authority and then you try to topple it. So you destabilize the nation. Okay, synonyms: destabilize, unsettle, overthrow, depose, or demolish. So basically, in Hindi, it means kharab kar dena. Dignify, you respect, you provide dignity, honor, enhance, or enrich. Because here you are destructing or disturbing everything. But when you enrich, you are adding some value. Example, since the prince was in a hurry to become king, he wanted to become king, he planned to subvert his father's influence. He wanted to topple or unsettle his father's influence by convincing everyone that the leader was insane. So this is all about today's video, and if you like it, don't forget to press the like button, subscribe to our channel, and share this video with your relatives or friends who are preparing for different bank exams. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep practicing and work hard, and do download the PDF from the description box.